Hello and welcome to my latest Doctor Who review. Doctor Who. Doctor Who. Midnight. Midnight.
I think I'll cut to the titles.
Now. Hello, Whovians, and welcome to my latest review of Doctor Who, where today I review Midnight, the 196th Doctor Who story overall, starring David Tennant as the 10th Doctor. Okay, so Midnight. This will be an interesting one to review. So the plot of this episode is as follows. The Doctor and Donna go to the leisure planet of Midnight for a simple, relaxing holiday. However, life with the Doctor can never be that simple, and things go horribly wrong for the Doctor when he decides to go off on a bus trip to see a sapphire waterfall, starting with the bus shutting down. When a mysterious entity infiltrates the shuttle bus, no one is to be trusted, not even the Doctor himself. Okay, Midnight. Now, I had a bit of a weird relationship with this one. I wasn't really a fan of it when I was a kid. I don't know why, I just couldn't get into it when I was younger. On several rewatches, I've grown to absolutely love this episode. For years, I wondered what it was that made people so captivated and so entranced by this one, and I think it's very clear now to me why it is that. To me, Midnight is a fantastic Doctor Who story, and it's a tension builder. You know, it's not an adventurous story. Maybe that's why I didn't like it so much when I was a kid. We don't actually know what the entity is that is tormenting the people on the bus. We never find out. And I think in a way that works to this episode's strength because the audience are constantly on tenterhooks, and it also adds to a rewatch value. Even watching it now, I completely felt the tension, and we gradually start to see all these people, including the Doctor, everybody's panicking and getting worried, and things just start to escalate. We gradually see the fear and the tension just rise dramatically, and it's a slow burner, but it's a great one in that respect. As for the creature, or whatever the hell it is on the planet, all we know is that it infects Sky Silvestri, and then she starts repeating everybody, and then whatever it is latches onto the Doctor, and then the Doctor starts repeating Sky. But so whatever this creature is, it is evolving at a rapid rate because of their speech. It's listening to the humans and the Doctor talking, and it's learning, it's evolving, it's growing. So I think the idea of the whatever this creature is pretty cool. It's a shame we don't know what it is, but in a way I'm actually glad about that. It works in favor of the episode. And it just goes to show how sometimes the human race can be arseholes. The Doctor has gone on record many times as saying how much he loves the human race and loves the Earth, but these humans are despicable. This is one of the best supporting casts for any Doctor Who episode, in my opinion. We have the hostess, played by Raki Ayola. She's very good, actually. She's one of the nicer characters, actually, and her sacrifice at the end is very powerful. She stops them from throwing out the Doctor into the onto the planet of Midnight, because actually on the planet of Midnight it's just sapphire and waterfalls, and the air isn't breathable for anyone, so they have to look at everything from a shuttle. So obviously the hostess dies sadly. Leslie Sharp as Sky Silvestri, she gives a very good performance because she doesn't really play Sky for that long, and then before she suddenly becomes possessed or controlled by whatever this entity is. It doesn't have a name, we don't know what it is. So it's just this kind of thing that takes hold of her, and she's very convincing, and it's very scary when she's just sort of sitting in the corner, and then she's got these big bulging eyes looking out, and how she's terrifying everybody else. David Troughton as Professor Hobbs, is also a very good character. Although he's actually not the kind of nice professor you think he is. He actually goes a bit dark as well, like some of the others, and he kind of joins in the campaign to throw out Sky and the Doctor. And his assistant, Dee Dee Blasco, played by Aisha Antoine, she's also quite good, and she's actually one of the good ones as well. She does question the Doctor quite a lot, but in the end, she does, you know, have a clearer understanding of what's going on. She's the one who sees that it's, you know, that Sky is still very much, you know, gone. It's, you know, she's not free from this entity or whatever. She knows that Sky is gone, but the others are just think that this thing transfers between bodies, but no. We also have Biff and Val Kane, who are husband and wife, and their son Jethro. Lindsay Coulson plays Val, who's actually famous for being in EastEnders. Another EastEnders connection. Who would have thunk it? Of course, Colin Morgan plays Jethro, and we all know that Colin Morgan is Merlin in the BBC show Merlin. And he's pretty good here. I like Jethro. He's, at first, appears to be one of the ones who kind of is more on the side of the Doctor, and he's kind of seeing things the Doctor's way. But it's actually interesting how quickly these people turn on the Doctor. The Doctor in this episode is interesting. David Tennant. I mean, we get a new perspective on him this time, because the Doctor does act very pompous and very arrogant this time, and very sanctimonious, shall we say. Like, he does go on about how clever he is and how much he kind of knows and everything, and these people don't really like his attitude, and they don't trust him. They don't immediately gravitate towards him like a lot of other people have done in previous stories. But this story acts as a very good contrast as to how people's attitudes towards the Doctor and the situation change, because in this situation everyone's just panicking hysterically. They can't calm down. The Doctor's trying to get them to calm down, and he's trying to convince them not to throw Sky out of the shuttle, and throw him out as well, because they're all thinking about murdering, and he's like, no, could you actually do that? Could you actually really murder? So it's a really interesting piece of drama, because you just see how, in this very intense, secluded situation, how far these people will go. Like, there's a real extremity to this story, and the stuff where everybody's repeating each other, it's very scary. It's an incredibly scary story, and the music as well by Murray Gold is amazing. This is some of the most intense pieces of music that Murray Gold has ever composed, and it sounds amazing. And the visuals for this story are amazing as well. Like, the look of the planet is just incredible. The CG looks very effective. Sadly though, Catherine Tate as Donna doesn't really get to do that much because she's sunbathing. But I'm going to forgive it, because Donna actually gets to do a lot in the next story. The next story, Turn Left, is a very, well, it's a Donna-focused episode. So, but it is a shame that she's not really in this one that much. And also, we do get a little bit of a tease of Rose. Yes, Rose is coming back very soon in the next story, actually. But we get to see her on the TV screen when the Doctor stands up after everybody's crashed, and she's mouthing the words Doctor. We can't hear any audio, but we know it's her. So it's a nice little tease there. The beginning of the story is quite good, and it's quite calm, the way everybody's sort of getting to know each other, and then as soon as they crash, bam, we're in. It's a great tension piece. It's a great drama. It's a great piece of drama. That's why I love it. So I think Midnight is a terrific Doctor Who story. This is an excellent story. It's very well paced. It's dramatic. It's intense. It's a different perspective on the Doctor, humans, and what people do in intense situations. And the fact that it's mostly set in this secluded kind of bus shuttle is really interesting, and again adds a certain amount of claustrophobia and tension. I mean, tension is absolutely the word I would use to describe this story. So to wrap it up, I'm going to give Midnight a 10 out of 10. Some people might find the sort of constant bickering and stuff annoying, but it didn't actually bother me this time. It used to bother me, but not anymore. And now I get it. I get why people love this one. So that's my review of Midnight. Thank you all very much for watching, and stay tuned next time when I review Turn Left, which will be the penultimate story of Series 4. So until then, I'm Mr. Thomas 11. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye for now.